Alright, so in this video, we are going to build a website using Python and StreamNet. With StreamNet, you can create entire web applications in Python without needing to know HTML, CSS or JavaScript. We are not just going to build the website, we will also deploy it to the internet. The website itself is quite simple, yet it has some really cool features. First of all, we will make use of query parameters. As you can see here in the URL, I have specified the name Kartik. So this name is also displayed on the website. Additionally, we will insert an animation and add a snowfall effect. Instead of snowflakes, you can also choose any other emoji you would like. So, without further ado, let us dive in. Okay, before we start coding out the app, we need to organize our file and folder structure. So, let's create a couple of folders. The first one will be .streamlit. Next, I will also create an assets and style folder. Once we have our directories in place, let's look at the different files we are going to need. First and foremost, we need our Python file, where we will write our code. In my case, I will call it streamlit_app.py. Later, for deployment, we also need to tell the web server which packages it needs to install. We will do this within requirements.txt file. For now, we will leave it empty, but we will come back to that file in just a moment. Next, let us take a look at the configuration file for StreamNet. Inside the .streamlit folder, I will create a file called config.toml. In this file, we can specify the theme colors. By the way, this is optional, so you don't need to have this file. However, if you want to have the same colors like in my app, you can just copy the file from my GitHub page. Or just simply go to my GitHub repository and copy and paste the content from there. I will make sure to include the link to this GitHub repository in the description of the video. Okay, with that in place, let's now place the Lottie animation in the assets directory. This is the little Happy Holidays animation. But feel free to pick any other animation. You can find them for free on lottiefiles.com. Just create an account and download the animation as a JSON file. Alright, now inside the style directory, I will also create a style.css file. This file will be pretty straightforward. By default, StreamNet comes with a colorful header and a hamburger menu, but I would like to hide those elements. We can do this with just a couple of lines of code. By the way, in the latest version of StreamNet, they removed the Made with StreamNet footer. So that is why I didn't include it in our CSS file. Okay, and as promised, let's now take care of the requirements. So the third-party packages we are going to need for this project. Of course, we will need StreamNet. Next, we will also need StreamNet extras for the snowflake animation. And last but not least, StreamNet Lottie to insert the animation in our app. Okay, and now we also want to make sure to install those packages on our machine. To do so, I will open a terminal session in the current directory and then type pip install -r requirements.txt. This will install all the packages we just specified. Once that is done, let me open our Python file and code out the solution. First things first, I'm going to import the packages. In addition to the third-party packages, we will also need the standard Python module pairflip and JSON. Okay, once we have imported all the packages, let's first take care of the different files and folders. To get the directory of this Python file, we can use pairflip and write it like this. Now that we have our current working directory, we can construct our file paths. So our CSS file is located inside the styles folder. Next, I will define the path to the assets folder. And inside this asset folder, we will find our Lottie animation. And speaking of the Lottie animation, let me write the function to load and display the animation. All we need to do is to open the file and return the JSON content of the file. Next, I will also write the function for the snowfall effect. And this is pretty straightforward. From the StreamNet extra package, we have imported rain. Now I will just contain it in my own function. Here you could also specify the emoji, font size, falling speed and animation length. By the way, to insert emojis, you can either Google them and then just copy and paste them here, or on Windows, you can open the emoji menu by pressing the Windows key plus the period key. Next up, I will create a function to get the name from the query parameter. As I have shown you in the intro, we use a query parameter called name. So in the first step, I will simply get all the query parameters and then return the value from it. If it's missing, I will just use friend for the name. Alright, once we've got that in place, let me set up the basic page configuration and specify the page title and page icon. Next, we can trigger the snow animation
and also apply our custom CSS. To inject our CSS code, we can open the CSS file and include the content of that file between HTML style tags. Just make sure to set unsafe allow HTML to true. Next, I will also display a header with our name, which is coming from the query parameter. So, first I'm using our function to retrieve the name, and then I will pass that name into the header element using an fstring. After that, I will display the Lottie animation, and for that we have already written the function. Now I just need to call our function to get the JSON content. Once I have the JSON content, I can pass it into the stLottie object and provide a key and set up the height. Okay, and with that we are almost done. The last step is to write a personalized message to the name we have already received. In my case, I will simply use a markdown element. Okay, once done, let me save the file and go back to my directory. From here, I will go back to my terminal and spin up our app by calling streamlit run and then the name of the Python file. Alright, and this is how our app looks like. By default, it is using the name friend. But if I now specify the query parameter name, we can see that the content of our app changes. So, this seems to be all working. However, currently it's only running on my local machine, meaning only I have access to this app. To make it accessible on the internet, we need to deploy it. For that, I will be using the Streamlit Community Cloud. But before we can use the Streamlit Cloud, we need to deploy our code to GitHub. Now, there are several ways to do that. You could, for example, just manually upload the file to GitHub, but I will do it through VS Code. So, here on the left side, I can click on Source Control and initialize a Git repository. As the next step, I will commit our changes. Once committed, we can also publish this branch. So, when I click on the button, we can specify a GitHub repository name. I will call mine Streamlit Happy Holidays, and then I will push it to a public repository. Okay, and once that is done, we can check out the files on GitHub. Alright, so everything looks good and we are now ready to deploy our app. For this, I will search on Google for Streamlit Cloud. Navigate to the first link that pops up and log in. Once logged in, click on New App and select the repository we just deployed. By default, it will use the main branch and in my case, my Python file is called streamlit_app.py. For the URL, I will choose Happy Holidays. Alright, the deployment might take a moment, but once done, you should see your app. Once again, by default, the name will be friend, but you can change that by specifying the name in the query parameters. Alright, and now you can share this link with your loved ones. And if you are watching this video at the end of December, I wish you all a happy holiday season. Take care and stay healthy, and all the best to you in the next year. And as always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.